Desperate times call for desperate measures, and that goes for everybody. Every living thing on this planet has to evolve to survive and adapt to all sorts of challenges just to get a good meal. The very basic principle behind the concept of survival of the fittest. But sometimes you're just really, really hungry. As you can see from these unique eating habits, these fascinating animals are at times terrifying, often unbelievable, and occasionally adorable. Sometimes at the same time. But you gotta do what it takes to fill your belly. So here is our list of 15 top badass ocean creatures that eat land animals. Don't forget to smash the like button, subscribe to The Supreme, and click the notification bell for more lit content. Let's get rolling. Number 15, killer whales, orcas. Or killer whales, as they're more commonly known, are top-level predators in the ocean and the largest predator of warm-blooded animals alive today. Around the world, killer whales appear to have an extremely diverse diet. Globally, killer whales have been observed preying on more than 140 species of animals, including many species of bony fish, sharks and rays, and 50 different species of marine mammals, and yes, land animals on occasion. And they're incredible hunters with many tricks up their sleeve. Researchers observed killer whales hunting cooperatively using a carousel feeding technique. They cooperatively herded small fish into a tight ball close to the surface. Then the whales stunned the fish with their tail flukes and chowed down. To hunt a large whale, a pod of killer whales may attack the whale from several angles. Witnesses recently watched about 30 killer whales attack a 60-foot blue whale. Now, how's that for teamwork? And these black fish, as indigenous people used to call them, do not waste time. They don't chew their food. They swallow their food whole or may tear or shred it. But because they can live with their families or pods, they always share, most of the time. Number 14, catfish versus pigeon. Sir David Attenborough once said about a very common bird, "Losing its fear of humans has enabled one animal to spread into cities everywhere and in huge numbers, and that's pigeons." And sometimes the right place at the wrong time, however, as some pigeons were seen bathing in the river, an underwater predator made its way upstream. In a split second turn of events, the predator, a whale's catfish, dragged one of the pigeons by its wing and dragged it underwater to eat. Now, pigeons are a favorite food of many animals like falcons, cats, turtles, and pelicans are just a few of the hungry critters that eat them. But pigeons also face treachery from an even more sinister and unlikely foe. Deep beneath the dark waters of ponds, lakes, and rivers in Europe, a creature with an insatiable appetite dwells. This creature is none other than, yep, you guessed it, the whale's catfish. Growing up to 13 feet in length and weighing up to 880 pounds, these catfish are truly monstrous. And aside from eating pigeons, they also dine upon annelid worms, insects, gastropods, crustaceans, other fish, frogs, mice, rats, and aquatic birds such as ducks. And with stealth and finesse, as you can see, they capture their prey and drag them to a watery grave. Number 13, archerfish. Archerfish are incredible creatures with incredible aim. They lurk under the surface of the water in rivers and seas, waiting for an insect to land on the plants above. Then suddenly, and with unbelievable accuracy, they squirt out a stream of water that strikes down the insect. The insect falls, and by the time it hits the water, the archerfish is already waiting in place, ready to swallow it up. Because they have more developed eyes than most fish, the binocular vision allows them to focus forward and judge longer distances to aid their hunting technique. The shape of its face is pointy around the mouth. This narrow profile allows it to have precise aim when taking down prey, like a personal super soaker. While archerfish mouths go above the surface to shoot down prey, the rest of the body remains submerged. And if you've spent any time in a swimming pool, you'll know that light bends when it enters the water. A less astute fish might not correct for this bending of light and would be tricked into thinking that the insect is somewhere it isn't, but not the archerfish. This little aquatic physicist is able to seamlessly correct for the bending of light, and because of gravity, spit doesn't fly in a straight line. because the earth pulls it down. The archer fish understands this and nails it anyway, no problem. Number 12, rabbit eater. The silver arowana, also known as the dragonfish or monkeyfish, is a freshwater fish indigenous to South America. Renowned for its hunting ability and large size, this fish is one of the most iconic around. Also known as the dragonfish or monkeyfish, these impressive creatures are strong, powerful swimmers and can be fairly aggressive at times, as you can see by its rabbit-eating abilities. Its most distinguishing characteristic is its jawline. Affectionately referred to as a drawbridge, their mouth is nearly vertical, which makes a rabbit a quick and easy meal with its huge mouth. And who says fish can't jump? Arowana fish can even leap out of the water and hunt animals on low-level branches. This fish is not playing. They're a predator fish that can weigh in excess of 12 pounds, with silver and gray coloring, and can grow to 4 feet in the wild. And believe it or not, people love to keep them in giant aquariums. However, when kept in captivity, you should expect them to grow to around 3 feet. And be careful if you get close to the water. You do not want this freshwater fish to make lunch out of your hands or feet. Number 11, tiger sharks. Maybe it's a bit unfair, but tiger sharks have a reputation for being the garbage cans of the sea. They'll eat just about anything, from dolphins and sea turtles to rubber tires. Tiger sharks are even known to take a bite out of humans when their paths cross in the wild. But before these top predators grow to their adult size of 15 feet, younger tiger sharks have an even more unusual diet. Tiger sharks eat birds too, and not seabirds like gulls or pelicans, familiar backyard birds like sparrows, woodpeckers, and doves. So I guess lots of birds are on the menu at Chez Shark, and scientists finally have evidence that tiger sharks eat songbirds that primarily live on land. And this behavior is closely related to migration patterns of our winged friends. Sharks were in the Gulf of Mexico during migration season. In every instance, the timing of the tiger shark eating the bird coincided with the peak sighting for that species during these periods. At a spawning site close to Hawaii, mommy and daddy albatross will help baby albatrosses learn to fly and hopefully leave the nest. But like in a 70s creature feature film, tiger sharks are waiting in the water to pick the young birds off as they spread their wings to fly. That's messed up, tiger shark, but we forgive you. Number 10, walking catfish. Listen carefully because we're going to blow your mind. Walking catfish can walk across land. These fish like to move from one body of water to another in search of food or a better living space, and they do this by wiggling their slimy bodies across the land. They use their pectoral fins to stay upright, and in a snake-like movement, manage to make it across land, usually during wet weather. They have a special gill structure that allows them to breathe atmospheric air, and their elongated bodies are covered in a slippery mucus that protect their skin when out on the water. The classic cat's whiskers catfish have around their mouths help them locate food in murky waters and low light, so they can indiscriminately feed on insects and crustaceans, eggs and larvae, smaller fish, and a wide variety of plant matter. When food options run low, they move to another body of water to find more to eat. This non-native species was introduced to Florida by humans in the 1960s. The walking catfish thrives in our climate and prefers the stagnant or slow-moving waters of ponds and canals that can be found in the southern states like Florida. Ironically, the most significant negative impact of the walking catfish may be that it invades commercial aquaculture facilities and devastates fish stocks. Number 9, mudskipper. Mudskippers are funny little carnivores, googly-eyed fish that feed on worms, bugs, and small crustaceans. But unlike other fish, mudskippers are able to survive on the solid ground during the low tide. It breathes using the gills, mucous membranes of the throat and mouth, and dense capillary network in the skin. Reaching 2.75 to 9.75 inches in length, mudskippers like to rest on the roots, rocks, and other objects located above the surface of the water. Too much time under the water can actually kill them. So before surfacing to catch something to eat on the land, they fill their mouth cavities with water to create a hydrodynamic tongue that helps them catch and swallow their prey, literally moving the inside of their mouths to create a flow of water, drawing their catch in. Cool, right? Mud skippers can also jump 2 feet in the air and climb on various structures thanks to sucker-like pelvic fins. And amazingly, the eyes of a mud skipper move independently of each other. They can visualize objects above and below the surface of the water at the same time. And for fish lovers with aquariums, mud skippers can be kept as pets. They can be trained to take food from the hands of their keepers. How about that? Number 8. African tigerfish. Researchers in South Africa captured the first video footage of a freshwater fish lunging out of the water and snatching a bird in flight. Normally, freshwater fish, including some bass species, eels, and piranhas, have been shown to occasionally prey on birds that are swimming in water or sitting on land close to the edge of the water. But for the African tigerfish, researchers think that these feeding habits have been adopted out of necessity due to limited availability in regards to food, so they developed alternative hunting methods. Tigerfish have to spot a fast-flying swallow from the water, exceed the bird's speed, compensate for refraction, or the fact that the angle of light changes when it goes from air to water, and then leap out of the water to grab the bird. And gotcha! The act is risky though. By preying on different birds in the air, the African tigerfish leaves itself open to being preyed on by other birds, including the African fish eagle. Hello! Tigerfish are some of the eagle's favorite food. During the study at Schroeder Dam, the fish jumped out of the water like crazy, and in 15 days of testing, they ate 300 barn swallows. Number 7. Dog eaters. Imagine a ferocious carnivorous fish that can grow up to 3 feet long, is armed with a row of razor-sharp teeth that can cut through flesh like a fork through jello. Meet the snakehead fish. Oh, and it could eat your dog. Native to Asia, northern snakeheads are often called frankenfish, thanks to both their ability to breathe atmospheric air and can crawl around land. Yes, land, by using their fins for up to 4 days on end, or more if they're burrowed into mud. The worst part, however, is their set of gnarly, spiked pearly whites. And thanks to human error, these crawling fish arrived in the United States accidentally by aquarium owners who thoughtlessly set them loose, and by people in the live food fish trade who released them in the wild to establish a food source. Actually, the worst part about these carnivorous fish is this. Snakeheads have a habit of completely destroying the food chain of environments they take over. Back in 2002, the Washington Post did a report on the troublesome fish, deeming the snakehead species as freakish. The article quoted a Maryland biologist as saying, "It has no known predators, can grow up to approximately 15 pounds, and can get up and walk. What more do you need?" Yeah. That's kind of freakish. Number 6. Rainbow trout. Picture it. A tiny shrew-hunting insect along a stream bank slips into the icy water. It swims frantically to reach shore, using all its energy to stay afloat. Just as it appears the small critter might make it, an almost imperceptible ripple appears, and then the water explodes. The surface soon calms, but the shrew is gone. It's rainbow trout for the win. As you know, it's no secret that other fish will eat small mammals and can be considered a major part of a fish diet. A study recently documented that rainbow trout actually zone in on little mammals every 2 to 3 years, when the little critters may be at a peak abundance, much as trout will focus on mayflies or caddis flies when these insects hatch. So the small mammals provide important nutritional value to the rainbow trout. But how do the shrews wind up in the water? In trout-friendly water basins, the phenomenon could be associated with flooding, where small mammals are washed into the stream with heavy rain. But there is a species of water shrew that swims and hunts aquatic prey. But this predation may simply come down to abundant prey near the water. So try your luck, but don't hold your breath, shrew. Number 5. Leopard seals. Female leopard seals, the larger of the two sexes, can reach weights of 1,300 pounds and grow to lengths of up to 10 feet. Their bodies are long and slender, and their heads appear to be almost a little too large for their thin, serpent-like bodies. This specialized, streamlined body shape is excellent for propelling them through the water at speeds of up to 25 miles per hour. But they do not play well with others. Generally, they hunt alone. Yet, oddly enough, sometimes they smile. The ends of the leopard seal's mouth are permanently curled upward, creating the illusion of a smile or menacing grin. And they sing? Yes, indeed, they do. During the breeding season, leopard seals can become extremely vocal. These features add to their already intimidating presence and is not to be trusted. They're potentially aggressive animals that will always be keeping an eye out for the next meal, even if that means feeding on land. They'll defend their personal space by issuing a warning growl at anything that comes too close. Orcas are currently the only recognized predator to leopard seals, but if they manage to escape the wrath of the killer whale, they can live up to 26 years old. Number 4. Great White. Graphic video warning. Video has emerged showing the moment of a great white shark hunting, catching, then ripping apart a seal in front of tourists in Canada, in the third such attack in the past month. The violent incident unfolded as the Jolly Breeze tall ship sightseeing vessel passed near Greens Point Lighthouse in the Bay of Fundy, New Brunswick, Canada. And scenes like these are extremely rare in nature, even though these sharks are found all over the world, in preferably colder coastal waters. They grow to be about 15 to 20 feet or more and can weigh more than 5,000 pounds. Great white sharks are amazing hunters too. It's hard to imagine this huge eating machine launching itself out of the water while hunting, but the great white shark does just that. This spectacular behavior is called breaching, and great white sharks breach in order to catch fast-moving prey like seals or any land-living mammals who might be on the great white's radar. Swimming fast at the surface, sharks can reach 40 miles per hour and fly 10 feet into the air. However, breaching is relatively rare because the shark has to use so much energy to propel itself. And look at those teeth! Number 3. Giant Octo. Sure, an octopus prefers to catch his meal and take it back to a secluded spot where he can eat in privacy. However, sometimes the opportunity for a meal comes up under some very special circumstances, and they use many tactics to capture prey. Sometimes they rely on their ability to camouflage themselves perfectly with the background. They just lay in wait for their dinner to come to them, grabbing it with their arms when it gets close enough or actively engaging in a chase. There are also those moments when the octopus uses its ability to reach and squeeze into the tightest of places. Remember, an octopus has no bones. This allows them to access nooks and crannies, which seem too small for him. And when this octopus wants to snack on this caged crab, he slides his arms through the cage bars and gotcha! Almost immediately, the crab's movements stop. As if paralyzed, the octopus manages to bring his beak close enough to pierce the crab and inject him with toxins and digestive enzymes, and then gulp. The octopus consumes the crab by sucking it through its beak. No need to pull the crab out, sort of like slurping on a crab milkshake through a straw. Thanks, but no thanks. Number 2. Horse attack. A badass great granny killed a 580-pound alligator she claims was responsible for eating her miniature horse. We think this is the gator that ate one of our miniature horses several years ago. Cochran, 73, sought revenge on the 12-foot swamp creature for gobbling up her pet pony 3 years ago at a ranch in Goodrich, Texas, USA. And now she aims to turn her prize catch into a pair of custom alligator boots. As big as this gator was, he could have easily eaten my horse, said Cochran, who used roadkill she found to lure the beast. But as anyone who lives near alligators knows, they can and will eat animals in the water and, of course, animals that live on land, even a miniature pony. And they have been considered problematic pets in many regions worldwide. But not for this stealth senior citizen. One shot in the head and he just went under. Boasted Judy Cochran to USA Today, gator hunting runs in the family too. In 2009, Cochran's then 5-year-old grandson shot and killed a gator in the same pond that was even bigger, 800 pounds and more than 12 feet long. Number 1. Pet crabs eat anything. you probably have seen huge tanks of crabs and lobsters in the seafood section of your local grocery store. Or maybe you've seen crabs in their natural habitat in oceans all over the world. But did you know that people keep pet crabs? They're omnivores, so they eat both meat and plants, but mainly they like algae or bacteria, other crustaceans, mollusks, worms, and fungi. But did you know that crabs don't seem to mind eating the same foods that humans like? And even more so, videos of this cutesy feeding fetish has gone viral. People just love watching these crustaceans literally crush up and cram into their mouths stuff like fruits and onion rings, basically table scraps like you would feed to the family dog. And full disclosure, the videos are hella cute. You kind of fall in love with these crabs, and yeah, I actually said that. I mean, just look at the red crab eating a banana. Is that not adorable? But if having a pet crab still seems a little strange, at least you won't waste any more food. Now, can they do the dishes? That was 15 badass ocean creatures that eat land animals. Thanks for watching.